Hey everyone, Havoc here. Gonna do yet another tank review. Today we're gonna do the IS-2. It's the Tier 7 Chinese heavy tank. If you've been watching my videos, I've been going down the line to the 113, and I've already completed reviews on the Type T-34 and the Type 58, which are all variations on the Soviet tanks, the T-34, the T-34-85. And now a variation of the IS tank, it's the IS-2. As you've seen in my previous reviews, I'm going to say once again, I'm going to make a comparison here between the IS-2 and the IS. I've done this for all the reviews so far, and the general consensus with each one of these tanks is that they are all lesser versions of their Soviet counterpart. And unfortunately, that holds true once again here with the IS-2. I've done comparisons between the IS and the IS-2, just as I have in the previous tanks, and the IS-2 does fall short in a couple ways to the IS, clearly giving the IS the advantage if you go tank versus tank. But once again, I must say that there are variations on very good tanks. That doesn't mean you can't have success in the IS-2 like you would in the IS. They're both really great tanks. They're very good at what they do. So I definitely suggest you play them and enjoy it. With that being said, the answer, spoiler alert, the IS-2 is inferior to the IS. I'm going down this line with the idea and the hope that some of these tanks later in the line are not necessarily inferior to their Soviet counterparts, but actually are just a different type of tank, a variation to the Soviet counterpart. And so far with the 110, I can say that that seems to be the case. I was hopeful for that. I haven't done any direct comparisons between the IS-3 and the 110. I feel like the tanks are just different, but I really enjoyed the 110 already. So there's a light at the end of the tunnel. I know people who have the Tier 9 and Tier 10 tanks love them, and they don't really sit there and cry about how they're inferior to the Soviet counterpart. Quite the opposite, as a matter of fact. I've heard a lot more grumblings about the IS-7 than I've heard about the 113, now that it's received its PC buff here on console. So, if you're wondering why we're going down this line and why we're going through some of these headaches, that's the answer. We're trying to get to the Tier 9 and Tier 10, and I think the Tier 8 might actually be something I look back on and say is a really great tank. So far, I've really enjoyed the Tier 8 right away. And some of it has to do with the grinding and some of the packages. And this IS-2, I think, is really hampered down by some of the grind. I'll get into the packages, I'll get into the comparison with the IS, and I'll definitely get into some playstyle. And I really suggest you hang on and listen to those things, because if you want to be successful in this tank, you're going to have to play it a certain way. And I know this from experience, because I did it the wrong way, and I had to actually go do some research on how to best play this tank and how to be successful. After first couple nights of making mistakes and not having success, some of which was matchmaking, by the way. But either way, I really suggest you hang around and listen to what I have to say about the tank in order to be successful. Otherwise, it's just going to be kind of a really painful grind. Anyway, so as I'm doing my reviews now, I'm trying to get some of the more important stuff out of the way. First, we'll go into equipment and do this real quick because it's really easy. There is no vertical stabilizer, so that staple item is not available. We're going to go with large gun rammer. That's obvious. We're going to go with GLD, and I'm going to explain why in a minute, because the gun is that bad. And we're also going to do improved ventilation, hopefully, to also jump on top of the idea of making this gun better. So gun rammer, GLD, vents. There's really no question. If you don't have any repair skills whatsoever, you could make an argument for toolbox. That's it. I mean, other than that, hopefully you have a couple crew skills already working. You're in a heavy tank. Repairs would definitely be a high priority item. So I would hope you wouldn't need the toolbox. But if you don't have repairs yet, then yeah, maybe I would do rammer, GLD, and then toolbox. But hopefully you do, and then you can go right to vents and get a little bit extra crew skill, which hopefully that crew skill will translate to some better gun handling, because you're gonna need it. All right. Let me talk about we'll talk about crew skills here real quick. Actually, I don't have the crew in here. I have it in the 110, but it's the same crew. I'm just building up the line, so no big surprises here. The changeover I had was from the Type 58 to the IS-2. As obviously, I'm going from a medium, rather mobile, speedy medium, to an IS, a totally different tank. So there was a huge changeover from the Type 58 to the IS-2. So my crew had to make a little bit of a transformation. I took some camo and view range skill off and switched them out. So if you remember, I went Sixth Sense, Brothers in Arms, Snapshot, Smooth Ride, and then I started working on repairs in preparation for the IS tank, which I did here. I swapped out camo into track mechanics, so Obviously, repairs are important. Gun skills are very important because the gun handling on the IS-2 is dreadful. And then I went to make a change where I took my mentor and threw that out and put jack of all trades. And as you can see, I'm training pain tolerance. The reason I did that is because I want to run a premium consumable on the IS-2. You need all the help you can get, especially when it comes to gun handling. You don't see it here in my consumable loadout, which I'll get to in a minute. But basically, a very high-level expert, I guess you could say advanced player, sometimes what we do is instead of foregoing a fire extinguisher, you can forego the med kit and have jack-of-all-trades and hopefully pain tolerance to go with it just to make it a little less painful. But basically, jack-of-all-trades means that your commander will take over for any downed crewman. They don't do quite as good as a job as that crewman did. But it's enough that you can make up for it. So if you lose your driver in this tank, I'll have my commander jump in the spot and take over for the driver. Does it drive quite as well? No. But it's a heavy tank. It's taking damage. And to be quite honest with you, I learned with the Type 58, I don't even care what the chance of fire is on the engine. On here it says it's 12%. These Chinese tanks, my experience so far has been you just can't trust it. You whatever that number is doesn't matter. I don't even look anymore. I didn't look in the 110. I'm not going to look going down the line. I'm not going to run a Chinese tank without a fire extinguisher. I choose to use automatic fire extinguishers because I've traditionally been a little bit slow on putting out fires. So I'm going to go with automatic fire extinguishers. Plus, I have like 20 of them in reserve. So that's me. I use automatic. As I said, going down this Chinese line, I've really kind of learned the hard way. Do not trust the chance of fire numbers for the engine. Just, you got to run fire extinguishers on Chinese tanks. I think everybody knows that. It's an age-old adage with Chinese tanks. The two things I know I've was told about Chinese tanks before I took this line was that they start on fire and that they are poor comparisons to their Soviet counterpart. And unfortunately, that has been true so far. So anyway, I highly suggest if you have the crew skills to do it, that you start to migrate towards a jack of all trades with pain tolerance scenario and forego the med kit. You can't afford the fires anymore. I couldn't take it. So that's what I did. To recap, crew skills, Sixth Sense, Brothers in Arms, Snapshot, Smooth Ride, Repairs, Track Mechanic, and jack of all trades with pain tolerance to allow me to use a premium consumable. Looking at the supplies here, I don't have the premium consumable on right now. I don't really know why, but I know I did run it in place of this small med kit for quite some time. So starting down here, automatic fire extinguisher for me. You can use manual if you're quick on the draw. I used the premium consumable here, and you can use a small repair kit or a large one, because God knows if you're ammo racked in this tank, you're really going to hate life. So you might want a large repair kit so you don't have to make that poor decision between your tracks and your ammo rack. But I have repair and track mechanics, so I'm really not looking to use a repair kit on my tracks, and I'm really using this for the big stuff like ammo racks. All right. Here are your ammo loadouts. Plenty of ammo on board considering the fact that this tank doesn't fire very often. It's a big, derpy gun. Long reloads. I think I used something like this. This is what I used, I believe, in all my games. Carrying enough heat in case you get into tier 9 games, because you're going to want it for tier 9 games. You're definitely going to want it for tier 9 games. And you're going to want it for special situations as well. I just don't like to shoot a lot of premium if I can help it. So I usually would say either go to a 2-to-1 configuration or a 3-to-1 configuration at the minimum with almost every tank. There is enough shells here that I feel like you can grab a couple HE shells for special situations. I don't remember in this tank really running out of ammo a lot, although it is possible. There's not that many shells on board, but as I said, you have a long reload, you don't fire very often. If you get 10 pens in a game, it's a great game. So let's say you get 10 pens and you fire 20 times. I mean, you're going to be low on shells, but anyway, I wouldn't be too concerned about running out of shells. With that being said, this is the loadout I went with. Okay. So that's, consumables, crew skills, and equipment. Let's talk about the tank real quick. As I said, I'll make a comparison right now with the IS. The one thing I want to show you guys before you even get in the tank is the gun. This is the fully upgraded gun, by the way. This is not the gun you're going to be using to grind. The gun you're going to be using to grind, you know, the very first package is a 122. People could look at the 100 mil and say, oh, you should use the 100 mil. And I tried it. I actually tried it for a couple games because it was zero XP to start with the 100 mil. It's the same penetration. It's the same 175 penetration. Yes, it fires more often. Yes, the aim time is significantly better and the accuracy is better. But it's the same pen. If you're going to be out there shooting with the same pen, I think you'd round a hit for a much bigger alpha. And this is a huge alpha difference, 390 versus 250. And the, you know, with the difference in rate of fire and stuff like that, I just felt like, you know, you're really here to have a heavy tanks gun. And this gun, let's at tier 7 to have 122 millimeter, this is a playstyle issue that we're going to talk about. But basically the playstyle with this IS-2 is you are a heavy tank at tier 7 that hits like a tier 8 tank destroyer. So when it comes to trading alpha, you're basically the king of the trade in these games, unless you're up against tier 9s. You're the king of the trade, meaning if they want to shoot you once and you get a shot on them, you win that exchange. So the key is how do you dictate the pace of the battle so that you're in charge of that one-for-one trade. I mean, ideally, you don't want to trade if you don't have to, but that's the gist of the playstyle. So as you see right here, we got the 122. It's same gun for these three packages, and they're actually really not that great upgrades. Nothing really happens until you get to this final upgrade. Now, the difference between the gun is very small from here to here, and that's something that bothered me. I said, well, it's basically the same gun throughout, so I'll grind it throughout. And when you get over here, you get a new turret, and technically it's a new gun, but it's a slight variation, as you can see here, with a 3.4 aim time, 0.48 accuracy, 175 millimeters of penetration, and like a 4.3 rounds per minute. So now what do we improve to? It's still a 3.4 aim time, but now it's a 0.46 accuracy, which you're all probably saying is just still really, really terrible, and it is. And then your rate of fire went up to 4.88, so you got half a round a minute more. The other thing that came with this, though, was that the turret changed. And I felt like, actually, that made a big difference. I don't have any specs talking about the weight between this turret and this turret, but the tank just seemed to be more free. I know as far as armor specs go, the shape of the new turret is much better for getting some bounces. And I think that the overall gun handling improved. I was really surprised that to go from this package to this package, a change in gun and a change in turret made what felt like a really big difference in the tank. So if you're grinding through the tank and you're feeling despair and you're getting frustrated, I have to say that the fully upgraded version of this tank is much better than the gun that you have to grind through. Even though on paper they look very, very similar. Now, I mean, let's take a look at this gun again real quick. This is one of the worst guns in the game. I mean, this gun right here makes the Fatherland gun look like a sniper's gun. I mean, it makes it look accurate. The Fatherland shoots 3.4 with 0.46 accuracy. Except it has a hell of a lot more pen. At 221 or something like that. So, this is one of the most inaccurate tanks guns in the game. Now you're going to go to the fully upgraded version. It's really not much better. Again, now you are really looking at the Fatherland's gun right here. As far as aim time and accuracy goes. So when you have a gun this bad, like I said, with the equipment, you're definitely going to be not only rammer because you don't fire very often, but you're definitely going to want to do GLD invents. And you're going to want your crew skills to be snapshot and smooth ride relatively early, because gun handling is huge with this tank, because this tank's all about the gun. You don't have much in armor, and let's talk about that here real quick. I was pretty disappointed playing this tank with the armor. That's where I think I got a little bit frustrated, or the most frustrated. I've compared this tank, the armor on the IS to the IS-2, and they have different armor profiles, especially in the upper plate area. But, I mean, this idea right here is pretty much the same, 120 millimeters on the lower plate and on the turret. As you can see on the lower plate, it's pretty flat, so they're not going to have much of a problem penning your lower plate. But they also pen your turret regularly, too. The armor on this tank is quite suspect, especially when you're going against your arch nemesis, the T-29 or the Tiger 1, who both tanks have much more penetration than you and have really no problem penning this tank. But if you look here, here's the upper plate, and what's interesting, too, is not only the upper plate. I like the angle on the upper plate for this tank. For the IS, you have actually 120 millimeters going around the top of the front, but it's much flatter. This is a better angle, but it is less millimeters. But notice that the upper front plate is also the same as the sides. So basically, you have the same armor all around your tank. I found that this tank is most effective using side scrape maneuvers. Basically, again, you have 90 millimeters in the front plate, or you have it on the side. Either way, it's 90 millimeters. But if you're using a side scrape, you're really adding much more effective armor to your side. If you are going to peek a corner, which you really want to do in this tank, it's one a peek and boom tank for sure. That is definitely one of the two top tactics I would use with this tank. I would use side scraping, and I would peek around corners at an angle like this. If you can see that front upper plate at this angle, I think is a lot more effective. And as you know, we said your lower plate is even more millimeters at 120, so that would make this very effective. You actually, at this angle right here, you'd want them to shoot your lower plate. But if they shoot your upper plate, you also have this this much of an angle, making it very effective. One of the big things with this tank and the playstyle is, look at where the turret is. It's a front-mounted turret. There's very little tank that's actually exposed compared to other tanks that are more, you know, turret more centered. There's a lot of there's a lot less tank exposed, which allows you to peek a corner, shoot at this angle. You could peek, not expose a lot of tank, and what you do expose is at a very strong angle. Peek, let your monster alpha gun go, and then withdraw back behind the corner of the building. Now that is the playstyle. This is a peek and boom tank, or you could use a side scrape, but either way, you're exposing your tank long enough to aim in, fire, hopefully pen, and then get back behind cover. If you can do that, if you can dictate the pace of the engagement, then you will be successful in this tank, because as I said, you have basically a tier 8 tank destroyer gun as far as the alpha is concerned. So nobody trades like you do at tier 7. That's where you win the battle. As far as engine goes, it's actually a pretty fast tank for a heavy tank. I wouldn't say it's a speedster. I will tell you right now, in those comparisons between the IS and the IS-2, the IS has a 700 horsepower engine. So the IS is much more maneuverable than the IS-2. But the IS-2 is a maneuverable tank. It's not a slow tank. I was actually quite impressed when it's fully upgraded with how well it gets around the battlefield. So that's not really an issue, but I have to say right now the IS has a bigger engine. Okay, so we talked about maneuverability, and we talked about play style. As I said, you want to peek and boom. You want to peek around a corner at this angle right here, exposing very little tank, letting out a really huge alpha shell, and then pulling back behind. Even if you have to trade and you take a shot, you trade better than anyone else. As I said, tier 8 tank destroyer gun, most alpha, tier 7. If you're not going to do a peek around the corner at an angle, you're going to want to do more of a side scrape maneuver. And you'll see these things in the gameplay, by the way. But you want to do more of a side scrape maneuver. If they do shoot you in the upper plate here at this angle, you're probably going to pen. I think I remember a scene where I was up against the T-29. It's in the gameplay. And I was in a side scrape, and he was just kind of standing there. And he killed my loader right through here. But then after that, all he did was track me. And he definitely died. And I ate him up in my side scrape. So look for that in the gameplay. Side scraping, peeking corners at an angle. These are your weapons, your defensive weapons. I gotta go right back to the gun here real quick. As I said before, one of the worst accuracies in the game. Look at the aim time, 3.4 seconds. It's really hard to aim for that long and not take a shot in return. Now you're gonna wanna rush some of these shots because you don't wanna take a shot. You don't wanna trade if you don't have to. So you're gonna try and snap a shot off without fully aiming in. It's 175 millimeters of penetration, and that was one of my biggest complaints. For this much aim time and this bad of accuracy, this poor gun handling, to have 175 millimeters of penetration is pretty low. Your competitors have much more. The T-29 and the Tiger 1 have no problems with pen. I know they are 198, I think, for T-29, and in the low 200s for the Tiger 1. So they're not going to have any problem penning you. They have high pen guns. You have 175 millimeters of penetration, which I know sounds like it's enough, and it will if you hit weak spots. But when you're aiming at angled Tigers, angled T-29s, and you have this poor of an accuracy, you're going to hit their upper plate, so you're going to bounce. And with this long of a reload, you really can't afford to be bouncing shots or missing shots. So penning your shots, especially against your tier 7 competitors, is really important. And it's hard to do when you only have 175 millimeters of penetration. And if you're in a tier 9 game, you're really going to struggle with 175 millimeters of penetration. So you're going to probably want to switch to your heat rounds. As I said before, this tank, you know, I had eight heat rounds here. I had a sneaking suspicion when I did the comparison between the guns on the IS and the IS-2. Something, it just seemed like at every turn, whenever there was a possibility for the Soviet variation of this tank to be a little bit stronger than the Chinese one, it's usually there. So I don't have an IS tank. Looking at the tech tree, I wasn't able to get this information. So I actually had to go online and do some research about the IS when I was looking at the IS-2. And wouldn't you know, I was right on the money thinking that I'll bet you anything that the Soviet IS tank shoots APCR instead of heat for its premium round. And sure enough, it does. So once again, add that to the list of little things that Wargaming has done to make sure that the Soviet variation of this tank is strong, much stronger than the Chinese variation. And I know you're saying, oh, heat versus APCR. Heat versus APCR, to me, it's a big deal. Heat is a terrible premium round. You really don't get your bang for your buck. I understand the penetration is going to be the same, but APCR has a much higher shell velocity, and it has a better angle of normalization. I understand that heat maintains its pen over distance, which sounds like a good advantage to have, except you're not firing any over distances with this tank. It's a terrible gun, and it's a terrible, terrible sniper gun. As a matter of fact, not only are you going to be side scraping and peeking corners with your front mounted turret, but whatever you're doing, you're going to be doing it up close and personal, because I can tell you right now, you do not want to snipe in this gun with this gun in this tank. You just do not want to do it. It is not what this tank does whatsoever. So much like the Fatherland is a more brawly version of an IS-3, which in my opinion is probably the most backhanded compliment I've ever heard for a tank, because it makes it sound like it's good at brawling, and that's not the case. The Fatherland's not better than the IS-3 at brawling. It's just worse at everything else that isn't brawling. And that's the same that goes for this IS-2, much like the IS tank. The IS tank is an up close and personal tank. Is it a brawler? Not really, but it can't snipe. So you have no choice but to be up close with someone else. And that's a real problem when you come into a tier 9 game. And that's where I said earlier, I had a lot of frustration when I first got into this tank. Some of it coming from matchmaking. I was just getting poor matchmaking. And matchmaking is very important to this tank. If you're getting really bad matchmaking, it's going to be very difficult. Because not only do you only have 175 millimeters of penetration, which doesn't do anything to tier 9 tanks, and then you have a heat premium round, which we all know gets absorbed by tracks or bounces all the time off angles. So you're going to have a hard time with using your gun, but the only way to use your gun is to get up too close to your enemy, because you can't snipe. This tank just doesn't snipe. It's a terrible accuracy, terrible aim time. And you can't afford to be standing out in the middle of the open either and taking shots from tier 9 tanks, because I'm telling you right now, tier 9 tanks are not afraid of your armor, and they're not afraid of your side scrape, and they're not afraid of you peeking a corner. They're gonna go right through you. So you're in a really bad situation with bad matchmaking, because now you have to get closer to the tier 9 tanks, and yet you really can't compete with them when you do. So just word of the wise, be careful when you run this tank. I hate to say it, but like I said, matchmaking is bad. If you're top tier, you are a monster. That Alpha is just crushing to lower tier tanks. I mean, you're one-shotting tier 5 tanks if you run into them. Most tier 5 tanks are a one-shot to you, really. Or at least you're completely crippling them, ammo racking them. I mean, you're devastating your opponents. The problem I had with top tier was running into T-29s and to Tigers. They out-DPM you, and you will bounce off their armor if they're angled and you don't hit it right, which is hard to do with this accuracy. With that being said, if you can dictate the pace of the relationship where you guys trade one for one every time and you're penning your shots, you're not bouncing, they will occasionally bounce off of you, and that's how you win those engagements. But if you're meeting in an open area where you can't protect yourself at all, I mean, worst case scenario, if you're meeting with them, you know, go to an angle, try and bounce some shots at an angle, but if you're being penned by them regularly, they're gonna win because they have the DPM on you, and they have the penetration, by the way, too, much higher pen guns. So, IS-2, I want to recap here, not only the playstyle, I think I've hammered that down as far as using your front-mounted turret to peek a corner at an angle, exposing very little tank, and unloading a huge alpha. You also want to use your side-scrape variations if you have a chance. If you're going up to a corner, you can just kind of side-scrape off it, and most of the time they'll hit your tracks a lot, so that's what you want them to do. You want to eat shots with your tracks, and then in return you want to deliver a huge alpha blow. That's playstyle. Comparison between the IS and the IS-2, let's recap as far as who's better and why. IS is clearly better once again. Reason being, it has a stronger, more horsepower engine, so it's more maneuverable. It has a different armor layout that pretty much looks to be towards the IS. It has 120mm skirt that goes around the upper plate. And this tank does not. It has 90 millimeters all the way around and in the front upper plate. And if you want to talk about the gun, they are almost identical guns with the exception of course, the Soviet gun fires APCR as its premium round, which APCR is clearly superior to heat, especially when you're talking about a tank that cannot snipe over long distances. So once again, the IS rules over the Chinese variation. And stick to your playstyles. Do the best you can with this gun. If you can make it work, that's why I said the equipment I said and the crew skills I said, because it's all about making this gun work. If you can make the gun work and dictate the pace of the engagements, you can have a lot of success with this tank. But it is very matchmaking dependent, unfortunately. And your teams are a big part of it too. This is not a solo tank. You don't want to be running alone, working a corner by yourself. You have a very long reload. Tanks who know your tank will rush you once you've fired. You need to be a support heavy. It's a support heavy. It is. And that's what it does. It rolls with the rest of the heavies. It's an incredible damage dealer. It is the hurt. You know, when somebody fires, that's when you peek around the corner and you lay down some serious alpha on them, and then you retreat behind the corner and reload. But you got to be working with other tanks in order to make that happen. All right, guys, I'm going to get some really great gameplay. As I said, I was pretty frustrated with this tank early on, but as it turns out, statistically, I actually did quite well in comparison to others that have driven it. So I'm glad to hear that. I did get the hang of the tank later on. It took some research. It took some discipline. I had to come up with a playstyle that worked for this tank and use that with discipline. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you out there.
Same shit. Same language.
I thought it would be the other language.
It's all English.
Shirt.
Sparky. I thought it would have been salute.
Salute? Then salute?
Salute.
Oh yeah, motherfucker, I got him. Loser.
Congratulations, you wanna hear it, Cookie?
T1 heavy.
Yeah,
it's
I
got it. Do you want a French cookie for that?
Whoa,
we got a lot of French cookies in Canada. We got lots of them. And we got Putin.
Yeah, you like it, Putin?
I thought he was Russian. I thought Putin was Russian.
No, Putin. Oh, like a surprise Putin. Cheese and gravy.
Surprise cheese.
La damia Putin. Bande Putin.
You got French toast. It's a good thing about the French. They're good at making French toast. Putin.
Destroyed my gun, my ammo rack, killed my commander, killed my driver.
Enemy armor is damaged.
There's nothing that can shoot you out on your left side.
We finished him off. Target locked. Unlocking target. Penetration. Enemy moving right at us.
Try to turn around and kill that medium.
Yeah.
Enemies in our base. The enemy knows the location.
I love how the tank that's with me doesn't even care. He's like, oh, let's get this damage, and then like, okay, like there's a KV-13. KV-13, he's like, meh. You don't care.
You shoot HE.
Oh yeah,
he hit you for 20 damage.
Oh, they're capturing our base.
They destroyed one of our tanks.
Yeah, is he gonna, that 12 ton gonna kill that? Is he gonna kill my guy?
Target locked.
Don't think so. He's hiding behind the dead.
What?
Black prints. Oh my god, this ARL is so bad.
Is he gonna?
Yeah, go back to base.
I know. I feel like the base. Yeah. I don't care if he dies or not. A minute. I have plenty of time to get there, but.
It's a capture.
What's waiting for me?
Oh,
well, it's tier 5, right?
I mean, you can shoot him once and take 90% of his health.
Yeah, but he can DPM the fuck out of me.
I just face hug him.
Been detected.
Oh, wow.
Releasing target.
Did you just bounce him or hit the dead guy?
I bounced the front.
The last one's left. It's all on us now. We pierced their armor. We lost a track. We're sitting ducks.
Oh, great.
Track's up. Let's go.
T-34, not worried about. 12 ton, worried about.
The T-34 is out in the field.
Like, see, if I leave cap,
like B0.
So what do I do if I leave cap?
I would just honestly stay there. There's a 12 ton. Holy crap! I can reload on that thing.
It's pretty impressive, but shit.
Dropping target. Enemies got us in their sights.
So bad.
Ready to
oh no! Oh no!
Oh my god.
He's out of APCR, dude.
Yeah.
Releasing target.
Nice. Nice. Thought we were gonna have another artillery moment there.
I shouldn't have done that. I was on his ass, and I'm like, dude, there's no way this isn't keep up with this tank. Ace wanker.
Nice. I guess so with that base XP.
That's an ace wanker.
Against me? So, I would love to go Valley, but I don't have any gun depression. I have, like, negative gun depression.
The enemy knows our location. Dropping target.
You guys ever seen a ram at this speed?
The track is damaged.
Slowest ram of all time.
Unloaded.
What's in the city? You gotta watch out because the Oni might come here. Ooh. We got here. Oh, yep, there's the Oni. M6. They're all waiting back there.
We've been detected. Unlocking target.
What is this? T-43?
bro. I got a side scrape bomb. This T29's gotta see what's going on here. Like, you're gonna track me. Oh. Fuck.
One of our vehicles destroyed. We got him. They've spotted us.
Yeah, it's a side scrape, T29. It's no good for you. Oni's a fucking problem.
They found us. Loaded and ready. Punched a hole in their armor.
What's behind me? Get out of my face.
They destroyed one of our tanks.
Where are we running from, Oni? Did anybody else just see an Oni walk by me like I wasn't even there?
Target locked. Just ding them.
Oh, my fucking loader's dead. Damn it. Yep. Oh.
Our team destroyed an enemy.
Dude, if I didn't have a dead loader, I think I could permatrack this. Well, I wouldn't need to permatrack him at this point, but.
Scratch another bad guy.
It's a pretty good game for the IS-2. I'm not gonna lie, I've been waiting for this game. Churchill's gonna cap. I guess the real question was, should I have joined him on cap? Hey, Sidious, what's up? Yes, I'm a leprechaun. An ace tanking leprechaun. So busy ace tanking that he can't stop ace tanking once you start. Doesn't get it. Well, I've seen what happens when we don't go north. It's not good.
Oh,
full bloom. A light tank? How did the Hellcat get up there?
Load it up. Let it rip. Unlocking target. Enemy in sight. Enemy got us in their sight.
I'm sorry, but that's kind of sad.
Right through. We've got a lock.
Fuck yeah, dog. Who wants some? Who wants some of this?
Enemies looking right at us. That one drilled straight through.
Who else wants some? You want some? Oh, that's SG-100Y. That shit's no good.
Enemy armor is destroyed. Ready to fire.
They HD modeled the map, so.
Besides that, all those bunkers and... Ah, fuck. Can't do shit. Medium to my right. Fuck me for not going with you guys.
And I don't want to tell you I told you so, but...
No! Come on, man! Alright, sorry. Breathe. Okay. He's an idiot. He doesn't even see me.
Oh, I can't do it. I've never seen somebody deserve it more in my life than just standing there. How brazen and bold he was. He's like, you can't hurt me. Yeah? Oh, I'm gonna hurt you. I'm gonna hurt you bad.
Come.
Target locked. They're hit.
I should have came with you guys. Climbable, you think? Which one?
That
hill? You can climb it. It'll take forever, but...
Never mind. I'll just go along.
Oh, did you see...
That part, I don't think so, but... You come there.
Watch that pen on the stream. It's pretty solid.
They've spotted us.
The one on the E2? As you're driving?
Yeah. Oh. Alright, General. There's a T-32 up on this hill. Let's give him the old Kobayashi Maru.
I just did.
Oh, shit. Oh! Damn it. I knew he'd go for me.
Like, I could get my kill in.
I just spent the entire game in a T-32 camping base as a tier 8 top tier heavy tank instead of and watch my team die at A1 and B2, but I'm gonna get this one kill on this tier 7 heavy tank who's been doing work the whole time. T-32, I curse you.
Curse him.
He got 800 damage and 2 kills, and I'll bet you that 2 kills makes him feel all good inside.
Just got my first.
They found us! Got
him! Thank you. Oh my god, that's so helpful. I was really getting worried about that.
The enemy knows our location.
M6 wants to drive out sideways in front of the ONI and see what happens.
We lost an ally. We got him. They destroyed one of our tanks. Locked and loaded. We didn't penetrate their armor. Enemies got us in their sights.
Real?
Gun, I fucking hate this fucking tank.